Hello everyone, Jacolo here. I know there was a severe lack of uploads on the channel for a week, and I'm sorry about that. I want to be clear with everyone who, for some reason, watches my content about why that happened. It's not a new piece of information for anyone who follows me on social media, links are in the description. But last week, my beloved guinea pig left the plane of the living due to too much liquid in the chest, stopping the heart in the process. Both I and my girlfriend were devastating, but were trying to cope with it. It's not easy. I was feeling so down that I didn't have the drive to do any videos. Here's actually the moment that I thank everyone who sent their best wishes for the little guy's health before passing, and their condolences to both me and my girlfriend afterwards. It was a hard time for me, still kinda is, but all that support made me shed a manly tear, or a thousand, don't judge me. With that sob story out of the way, let's go back to your regularly scheduled content. Since the game's inception, there was a discussion over which cards were better, more powerful, etc. The choices were changing due to the meta shifting into various directions and with new cards getting released in each set. That's why, to get the most unbiased opinion on the topic, we're going to the source, Konami itself. What I'll be focusing here are Konami blog posts, card design, and the TCG ban list. So, let's get started. At the bottom of the list, we have Raigeki, a part of the infamous Raigeki Silver Fang combo. This card is powerful enough to destroy all monsters on the opponent's side of the field. There are actually two factors that make this card a part of this list. First and foremost, there's the existence of a card specifically designed to counter it, called Anti-Raigeki. That trap not only negates Raigeki, but also redirects it to the owner's side. What makes it number 5 then? Well, that would be the fact that Raigeki has been limited since October 2014, and only has that one specific counter. The second last is Raigeki's brother from another mother, Harpy's Feather Duster. This spell was released from the forbidden section of the ban list in September 2020. It destroys all spells and traps the opponent controls. The counter is called Griffin Wing, which works similar to Anti-Raigeki, but for the back row. The reason this card is above Raigeki comes from the time it spent banned. It came back recently while Raigeki was limited for 6 years. The bronze medal goes to this card. What does it do again? This only has one hard counter in the form of Jar Robber, which negates the effect and lets the owner draw a card replacing itself. There are also two monsters that name Pot of Greed by name, however those don't negate but let the player draw an additional card, so aren't considered counters per se. What elevates this card to bronze is its status on the ban list, and that Jar Robber is a quick play spell, not a trap. That's it. Just close to being the most broken card in the game, we have Monster Reborn. This card is currently limited in the TCG, so that would make it weaker from Pot of Greed, which is third. So, why the number 2 spot? It all boils down to the specific counter cards, Call of the Grave and Call of Darkness. The first one negates the effect of Monster Reborn, while the latter sends all monsters summoned by Monster Reborn to the graveyard and prevents its further activation. Honorable mentions, everyone's favorite part of any list. So, we only have two over here, which are Chaos Emperor Dragon Envoy of the End, which had received an errata and released from its forbidden status on the ban list. It's also responsible for that status's existence. However, there's no card, no blog post indicating how powerful Konami thinks this card is, so that's why it didn't get to this list. And we also have Dark Hole over here. Just like Raigeki, it has one special counter called White Hole, but it didn't get a spot since it's unlimited. Some of you watching might be wondering, what is at the top of this list? What is the best card in Yu-Gi-Oh? And it's actually one that Konami stated is the strongest card to be released in 2017 in one of their blog posts. So yeah, that was a thing. This powerhouse of a card is so strong, Konami is too afraid to put it on the ban list. It's so powerful. It doesn't have an effect. Some of you watching might have figured it out, and for those who don't, it's Sea Monster of Theseus, a level 5 fusion tuner monster, which is summoned using two tuners as materials, and that's about it. And that's why you know it's the best card. Period. And that's be it for the list. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and all the good YouTube shit. Bye!